Project ARC, Action, Responsibility, Choice. And just a few things from their website and Facebook page. It shines a light on human rights, illumines empathy as a way to rise above insecurity, lights the way of responsible choice, sparks youth to action in their local and global communities, and then at the end it says, wants to visit your school or event. Well, this is the seventh year that Project ARC has been going to schools and to various venues and has been taking their powerful message. And I got to know Janice. Actually, Jim sent me an email about 14 months ago, and they were looking for space, and that's when the relationship began in terms of using our space and as well. So this is a wonderful gift to us to see some of the things that you are doing. And these are part of the cast. They're the ones that are here for today. There are others that also perform. They perform on Thursdays, most weeks, and they practice hard for 3 hours on Sunday. And I've had the privilege of watching them use this space and to practice for tonight on two occasions. And I must say that on both occasions, the emotion was welling up because it's a very powerful message. This is a message for the elementary schools that they go to, but it is such a powerful message that it really doesn't matter what age you are. This highly motivated, very energetic, and dedicated group of young people, dancers, actors, singers, social activists, have put their heart and soul into this project, and we look forward to hearing from them. And we thank their director, Janice, for making this happen. So I'm going to come down, and the rest of the service is going to be dedicated to their performance. And at the end of it, we'll have a prayer and a closing, and then they're going to talk to us a little bit about some of the things that they've been doing. So, Janice? And they don't use microphones, but you should be able to hear them quite well. And the other thing is that they expect you to participate. Okay? There is an expectation of participation. So you can sing, you can dance, you can roar, you can do all kinds of things, but they're expecting that. And the people in the balcony, you might want to move forward a little bit so you can see the things that are going on down here for those that are beyond the first couple of rows. Or come on downstairs, whatever is easier for you. I give to you Project ARC.
I will just use this microphone, but this will be the only time you'll see any of us use a mic today. I wanted to make sure that everyone in this congregation heard me say thank you. And I represent all of our cast when I give you the deepest appreciation for giving us your space every Sunday evening so we can continue to create this show. It is a labor of love for all of us. None of us get paid for this, but we do have the schools donate to various charitable organizations. So through the years, we've raised over $30,000 for those organizations. We come here every Sunday night, and we can't tell you how much we appreciate this congregation and the use of your church hall. And that's why we're so happy to be here today. You will see 10 of our cast members today performing. Two of the cast members you'll see today have actually left the show because they aged out, but they came back today because they really wanted to thank you as well. They haven't really aged out, but they did some things. They did some other things that kind of got in the way of Project ARC. We also want to make sure that we acknowledge and dedicate this particular show to the Bajo family. The Bajo family has gone through something that I, as a parent, cannot ever imagine. We have attended the vigil, and we just hope that the parents can see their way through with their family coming to support them soon. And we also want to dedicate this show to all the families who are losing people right now because of their desire to give their children a better life, a life free from war, poverty. That's all I have to say. Thank you, and please welcome the cast of Project ARC.
because if you're born, you have responsibilities. That's just the way it is.
Born.
Valid elected.
Rights.
Responsibilities.
Who? Rights and responsibilities go together.
You can't have a right without a responsibility to go with it.
You have a right to a free and safe life.
So have a responsibility to look both ways before and as you cross the street.
You have the right to your own things.
So you have the responsibility to look after them.
You have the right to join or set up groups.
So you have the responsibility to make sure that the group you belong to is not hurting anyone.
You have the right to safe water to drink.
So you have the responsibility not to waste water.
You have the right to live in a clean environment.
So you have the responsibility not to litter.
But ever since the dawn of time, ladies and gentlemen, just like some people forget about their poor belly button, and it gets all gross and litty and sticky, people have forgotten about human rights.
And ladies and gentlemen, just like some people have forgotten about their poor, gross, flinty, sticky belly buttons, people have forgotten about human responsibilities.
So, in 1948, the United Nations, a really big group of the world's people, reminded all of us that we have human rights. All of us. And that those rights need to be remembered and protected.
But remember, ladies and gentlemen, rights without responsibilities are only half of the whole of being human. It's really hard to clean just half of your belly button, so.
I have the right to a free and safe life, and I want to cross the street.
Sold into slavery, weaved carpets with his small hands.
escaped eventually, but got 12 shot dead.
Others caught the ball. Iqbal's story spread.
Gay pride parade, Israeli Shira, stabbed at 16. Same day in Palestine, baby killed. This is obscene.
Hatred fouls off to keep the hate going.
But they're gonna strike out when this murder pitcher's thrown.
40 million people live with ball and chain.
We can throw our hands up, or we can start a new game. You can be a ball of fire, or you can catch a snooze.
But the ball's in your court. If you don't play,
we all lose.
So, every child has the right to rest and play.
Okay, I'm going to play.
Quick, someone grab a responsibility for our right to play. Balance, we need balance.
I'm the responsibility to play safely.
So, let's put the right and the responsibility together. What do we have?
We have me playing basketball, and we have me making sure she doesn't run into the elderly woman with a bad back, a cane, bad eyes, and a cat on her shoulder. Meow! Walking on the sidewalk. Meow, 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 meow.
We have the right to be free, but to really be free, we have to choose to accept responsibility.
So, in 1948, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights was written. And in 1989, a Special Declaration of Rights, just for kids, the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child was created.
The UN Convention is a basic list of what kids are entitled to as soon as they're born.
Each birth entitlement or right in the list is numbered. Each numbered right is called an article of the convention.
It's hard to believe that in some places, kids don't know their own birthdays.
Article 8, you have the right to an identity, an official record of who you are.
Or have to work in factories, or even as soldiers, instead of learning or playing.
Article 32, you have the right to protection from work that harms you and is bad for your health and education.
It's unbelievable that kids are denied educational opportunities just because of their beliefs.
Article 30, minority or indigenous children have the right to their own culture, language, and religion.
And that to so many kids in the world. Death is real. And there's no cheat code to bring them back.
Article 6, you have the right to be alive.
The UN Convention is one of the ways the world is trying to take responsibility for human rights.
When we talk about human rights, we need to remember three things. Drum roll, please! Human rights are inherent. We are born with them, and they belong to each of us. They are not only by certain people or given as gifts. Number two!
Human rights are inalienable. People can't give them up and they cannot be taken away, even if governments do not recognize or protect them.
Number three!
No.
entitled Karaoke.
Welcome, Ewan. How are you feeling today?
Well, my parents are helping one of my grandparents at the hospital, or something like that. So I had to take the bus. It was 2 minutes late, and I had to stand up the whole drive. It had to be at least 15 minutes. Life's crap, so they're better.
Holiday.
This is so unfair.
In Tehran, Nafisa Azad's home is raided by
them on fire. His office is destroyed because he has proof of slaves being forced to pick cotton on cotton farms. His property is destroyed because he is a human rights defender.
So first, Taylor, I've been looking at your hair, and you really need my stylist for it. But he's in New York. Anya, when do I get to spin the wheel?
This isn't The Price is Right, Carrie. This is Name That Right. Do you see a gigantic wheel here? Are you listening to any of this at all?
Well, it's hard to listen when your nail is chipped.
Well, it's hard to listen when your brain is chipped.
Right. It's Article 17 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Everyone has the right to own property. I was talking about that before I got here, but I didn't really get it then.
Right again, Taylor. Ben, what's she going home with now?
Taylor, you have won a shopping spree to the secondhand clothing store of your choice. Buying used clothing is one of the best ways to make sure that your money isn't going into the hands of corrupt governments, some companies that use slave labor to grow cotton and sew clothing. It's also a lot better for the environment. The fashion industry is the world's second dirtiest industry, responsible for soil, water, and air pollution.
Should have tried door number one.
All right, we're getting short on time, so we're going to move on to the lightning round. If you know the human rights our actors are demonstrating, shout it out. Okay, so just feel it within prayer.
Right to health and medical care.
Correct.
What is yoga for $200?
Right to freedom of religion.
That's it.
Okay, class, our homework for today.
Homework? That's it. I'm out.
Right to an education.
Right again. And that's all the time we have. Wow, Taylor, you really know your rights.
Yeah, my parents taught me.
So, has the tribe spoken yet?
Yes, Carrie, the tribe has spoken, and you're out. Good luck on whatever island you're living on. Well, Ben, I think we have a surprise for Taylor here.
That's right, Nina. Taylor, here's your mom!
Hi, sweetie! You rocked this game! So before we send Taylor away with your final prize, we have a couple questions to ask you. Now, she wanted another iPhone. Did you hear her out?
Oh, yes, I certainly did.
Does she have a bed?
Of course! Her stuff is always all over it, but she has a bed. And we just finished painting her room, her favorite color.
Does she have a toothbrush?
Oh, yes, I get her a new one every 3 months.
Does she have some fun things?
Oh, yes, she has Netflix, and she has a camera, and a basketball, and her Dora the Explorer collectibles.
I'm sorry, Mom. I get it. I have lots of my own things. And I should have taken better care of my other phones.
The words of a winner. Ben, what final prize do we have for Taylor?
Well, Nina, there's one terrific thing that helps all of us make good choices, and one terrible thing that does its best to make us make bad choices. The terrific thing, and we all need it all the time, is perspective. And that's what Taylor is taking home with her today.
Perspective. Seeing what's really important. Realizing what's really important. For example, it's more important to have food than it is to have a glitter slime, even though I love glitter slime.
People are more important than things. I get it now. Best prize ever.
Now everyone in the audience go, aww. And thanks for joining us today on
Name That Right!
We have the right to be free, but to really be free, we have to choose to accept responsibility. Perspective. Realizing helps us make good choices, like being responsible.
To be greedy or to be thankful are choices we make too. Some of the world's poorest people are the most grateful, and some of the world's richest people are the most selfish.
There's a big difference between wants and needs.
Why would we think that just because we want something, we should automatically get it?
And so many people in the world would be grateful just to have
clean water,
a safe place to sleep,
food,
a safe place to learn,
and a peaceful family.
Article 13, you have the right to freedom of expression.
Thank you.
And we know that to live the best life we can, we need to balance those rights and responsibilities.
And having perspective.
Knowing what's really important
helps us remember our responsibilities and make good choices.
And become virtuous citizenry with an aptitude for stewardship.
Oh, so I was more like thinking like ninjas, but sure.
Okay, time to find out about the terrible thing. The thing that does its best to make us make bad choices.
It's atrocious, abominable, awful, dreadful, deplorable, distressing, painful, terrible, violent, crummy, lousy, rotten, brutal, and lame. Okay, I'm done. You folks want to take over?
It's evil.
Like racism.
Nefarious.
Like sexism. Nefarious.
Poisonous. Like homophobia. Poisonous.
Destructive.
Like terrorism. Destructive.
Nasty.
Like discrimination. Nasty.
Okay, so we're talking about insecurity.
Insecurity. Uncertainty or anxiety about oneself. Lack of confidence that may result in taking away someone else's rights in order to feel powerful.
Everyone is challenged by insecurity at times.
We're not bad people because we're being challenged by it. Each of us handles the challenge in different ways.
Insecurity looks different in different people.
Insecurity sounds different in different people.
I am such a loser.
Who cares about the test? It doesn't matter to me.
Everyone's looking at me. They're just waiting for me to screw up.
You heard me. Just back off.
Look at the way she walks. Who does she think she is?
No, it's okay. I don't mind. Really?
Why isn't he texting me back? What did I do wrong?
Look, it's just a joke. It's his stupid problem, not mine.
Insecurity feels different in different people.
I feel empty.
I feel frustrated.
I feel trapped.
I feel angry.
I feel hurt.
I feel alone.
I feel useless.
I feel worn out.
Insecurity invades people's lives in different ways.
My mom left my dad.
They really want
and how they really can be free.
We have the right to be free, but to really be free, we have to choose to get rid of insecurity.
It's hard, but it can be done. Perspective and purpose. Making responsible choices with yourself and others in mind are insecurity's arch enemies and your best defenses.
If the way you deal with insecurity is to beat yourself up or give someone else a hard time, you can change that. The first step is realizing that insecurity is your enemy, not you or anyone else.
Next, choose your own actions and attitude. Don't let insecurity control you.
And so we present a demonstration we like to call Choose Your Own Attitude. For this demonstration, we are going to need one person to come up and give us a hand. Any volunteers?
Your look or money or clothes or cell phone or anywhere you've been or anything you
of do.
The key is to remember that you always have a choice. And even if everyone else around you is making bad choices,
you can still keep making good ones. Light the way with art. Action, responsibility, choice.
Our choices make us who we are. Prisoners of war chose to sing to each other instead of giving up.
Terry Fox chose to raise money for cancer research instead of giving up.
Malala chose to fight for girls' right to education instead of giving up.
Black or white, women or men, Muslim or Jewish, no matter your race, religion, or gender, all of those people have something in common.
Even though life was hard on them, they chose to try to make it better for someone else.
They fought insecurity with four amazing tools: perspective, purpose, gratitude, and empathy.
Everyone has their hard stuff. Sometimes you're going to feel hurt.
But it gets better, especially if, while you're hurting, you think about how you can help someone else. Because there's always someone who needs you.
Insecurity will make you feel like you're alone, but it's not the truth.
A great man, Nelson Mandela, once said, "To be free is not merely to cast off one's chains, but to live in a way that respects and enhances the freedom of others."
So when you're feeling insecure, try not to concentrate on yourself.
Look beyond yourself and choose to help.
Because right now, there are billions of people who need you to help them stand up for their basic human rights.
Right now, there are thousands of threatened animal species who need you to help them survive.
Right now, there's a planet that needs you to take care of it. Right now, someone you know needs your smile.
So, when evil